Guess who's got his hand out looking for $5 million from the federal government, which obviously means $5 million of your dollars. Guess who wants $5 million to build a monument? I'm not going to tell you. You're going to have to stay tuned for this edition of Live Prayer.
What problems are you dealing with in your life right now?
Do you feel like giving up? Times are hard and you're not strong. Well, I know the answer for you, and it will lead to a truth. Don't look back to yesterday.
Now there are answers.
Tomorrow's on
Welcome
the
to
way.
Live Prayer.
It's waiting there.
Here's your host, Bill Kelly.
You can make it through. There is a hope.
And welcome to Live Prayer. I'm Bill Keller. It's good to have you with me on this Tuesday morning. Hey, everybody's good today, and I am so happy we've got through the Thanksgiving weekend. Had a great weekend up in New York. Wonderful service on Sunday. And I think everybody's kind of back in that little flow now for, 3 weeks? And then we kind of start shutting things down for Christmas and New Year's. But we've got a good 3 weeks to go before all that comes about. In the meantime, we're going to be here with you on MyTV8 every Monday through Friday morning, 7 to 7:30. And I'm so glad you've tuned in this morning. As today, we're going to talk about somebody in New York City that's got his hand out looking for $5 million federal dollars, that means your money, to build a monument. Who is it? What's the monument? I'm going to tell you in just a few minutes, so you don't want to go anywhere. I'm Bill Keller, founder of LivePrayer.com, the world's largest interactive Christian website. We reach a little over 2.4 million people around the world every day via the internet. I'd encourage you, if you haven't been there yet, or if you haven't been there in the last few days, come visit us, LivePrayer.com, the world's largest interactive Christian website. Unique content that changes every day. And one thing I can promise you, we've been online 11 years. I don't sell books. I don't sell tapes. I don't have a paid-for section. There's nothing to buy. There's only a place to come to be refreshed, to be blessed, to be challenged, to be encouraged, to be educated with great, unique content that changes every single day. So come check us out. LivePrayer.com, the world's oldest and largest interactive Christian website. You know, as I mentioned, we just got back from New York. We were there an extra day because we're in the process of tying down our permanent facility, of which we will be making a formal announcement on Wednesday the 1st. Because we pre-produce these shows a week in advance, you won't be able to find out about it here on this program till next Monday. But we're very thankful for everything God has done. We're very blessed, and we are looking forward to this incredible opportunity and challenge God has given us to bring the gospel to a very unique place in this country, ground zero. Literally 7 days a week we'll be holding services once we open that permanent facility. It's, again, a great opportunity not only to bring souls to Christ, but to bring a city to the saving knowledge of Jesus, a revival to the city of New York. Can you imagine what that would do? It would reverberate across this land from the East Coast to the West. And I believe this is the conduit that's going to bring this nation to its knees, back to God, back to biblical truth. The time is now, my friend, and we are positioned to make it happen. By the way, before we do anything else, I want to play for you a very... We're getting ready to come up on our first break in the morning, but I want to play for you a very special video. It's only a couple minutes, but I prepared it to share the vision of what this 9/11 Christian Center is really all about. You've been hearing me talking about it now for months and months. This is what we are all about. What I want to share with you today really drives home the vision. I want you to listen, watch, and catch the vision with me, and then I'll be right back. Stay tuned. I'm Bill Keller, founder of LivePrayer.com. Recently, it was publicized that the Muslims would be building a mosque at Ground Zero. Let me make sure you understand that this was a purposeful and premeditated act. This is not an accident. They already have many mosques in New York City. This was done in a very well orchestrated way. This mosque at Ground Zero will be a memorial to the greatest triumph of Islam in 1400 years, 9/11/2001, when their Muslim brothers flew those planes into the World Trade Center towers. More of their Muslim brothers went into the Pentagon. Others headed to the Capitol, were courageously ditched in the fields in Pennsylvania. But make no mistake about it, this mosque at Ground Zero is a memorial to the greatest triumph of Islam in 1400 years. It will be a place where they will teach this generation, future generation of Muslims, how to hate this nation, how to turn this nation into a Muslim land, which is their ultimate goal. They will teach people Sharia law, the law that Islam is governed by all over the world. What is our response as Christians? I thought and prayed hard about this. I decided that why hold another rally, another protest march, that a few hours after it was over, everybody would go home and forget about it. Nothing would change. I realize there are many great efforts to try to stop this mosque from being constructed. And while I pray they're effective, and while I pray that they will be successful, in my heart of hearts, I know that the Muslims, with their massive amounts of money, will be ultimately victorious. This mosque will be built. We don't need another protest. What we need is a bold, visible response to what the Muslims are about ready to do at Ground Zero. That response is the 9/11 Christian Center at Ground Zero. We aren't going there with swords. We're going there with the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is like Elijah on that wonderful day where he invited the prophets of Baal to Mount Carmel and said, "Let's see whose God answers by fire." Today, I issue that same challenge to Imam Faisal Raoul, the Imam of the Ground Zero Mosque. You bring your false God, I'll bring the God of the Bible, and we'll see which God answers by fire. Phase one, we will hold services every Sunday, starting September 5th at 11 o'clock through the end of the year at the New York Marriott, right by Ground Zero. As of January 1st, we'll move into our permanent facility at Ground Zero, where we will hold evangelistic meetings 7 days a week. We will have a special 9/11 memorial prayer room for visitors to Ground Zero and those who work in the financial district, those who live in that area, to come and pray. I know that as time goes on, the Muslims will try to silence me. They will try even to kill me. But the gospel won't be stopped. And I need you to help me. I need you to stand with me. Many people are outraged by what is about ready to happen at Ground Zero. And people say, how can my voice be heard? You can stand with me and the 9/11 Christian Center. Go to my website, liveprayer.com. On the left menu bar, click on the donation link. There is a secure server there where you can give via major credit card, you can give via PayPal, or you can just drop a check to our corporate headquarters in St. Petersburg, Florida. You can take a stand against this mosque, a meaningful stand, a stand that not only is going to drown out the lies of Islam, but it's going to lead souls to faith in Jesus Christ. I believe it's going to spark a revival in the city of New York, and I believe it's going to turn this nation back to God and His truth. Please, stand with me today. Your voice can be heard. You can make a difference. The 9/11 Christian Center at Ground Zero is the answer to this mosque and for this nation. I'm Bill Keller. God bless you. That's the 9/11 Christian Center at Ground Zero, where we'll be holding services at the New York Marriott every Sunday until the end of the year, 11 o'clock. I'll be up there, and then January 1st, we open the permit facility. We'll make that announcement to the national press on this Wednesday, the 1st of December. We'll have it for you on the show next Monday. All right, we got our first break of the morning. Watch these very important messages. And when I come back, I'm going to tell you who has got his hand out for $5 million tax dollars for his project. You won't believe it. Don't go anywhere. I'm Bill Keller of Live Prayer, and I need your help. God has challenged me to open the 9/11 Christian Center at Ground Zero. This is a response to the new mosque that's being built within a block of the World Trade Center towers used to stand. The Muslims are spending $110 million to build this mosque. God said to me to go put a Christian center within a block of Ground Zero, and that's what we're doing. We're going to open this center on Sunday, September 5th. I'll be flying personally to New York to hold those services every Sunday till the end of the year. And then starting January 1st, the center will literally be open 24/7. We'll hold evangelistic services there every day. We'll have a special 9/11 memorial prayer room so that those who come to New York City to visit that hallowed ground will have a place to come and meditate, pray, just spend some quiet time. This is a great undertaking. I can't do this alone. I need your help. To give a gift to the 9/11 Christian Center, you can go to liveprayer.com. Click on the donation link on the left menu bar. There you will find a secure server so you can make a gift with your major credit card, or you can give via PayPal. Or if you want to just drop a check to us, that's great. You can send that to our headquarters in St. Petersburg, Florida. That address is on your screen. In the information line of your check, just put 9/11 Christian Center. Your gift will go to this great undertaking. Islam is a 1,400-year-old lie from hell. The audacity of the Muslims to build a center in the shadows of where the Trade Center towers that their Muslim brothers knocked down, killing 3,000 innocent people, is a travesty. People are upset. I'm upset, but we're taking action. Sunday, September 5th. We will put our faith to the test as we open the 9/11 Christian Center at Ground Zero. I need your help. I need your prayers. I need your support. Thank you. God bless you.
Tired of political correctness?
I'm offended, therefore I am.
Tired of nothing making sense?
What is controversial about not killing your children?
Waiting for someone to tell it like it is?
To say that it's a peaceful religion, you have to reject all of its history.
The wait is over. The greatest battle isn't between good and evil. It's between truth and lies.
The most powerful weapon in the world is the truth.
Join Cloud 10 Pictures, Kevin Sorbo, and experts from across the nation as they tackle 12 big lies that are destroying our world.
What if the world we think exists doesn't?
Human beings are in some way twisted.
Women are clearly better. Make sure my wife knows I said that.
The industrialized world is dying.
According to the Quran, I deserve to be killed.
This is a holy war.
God exists. No way around this.
And if he existed, wouldn't you want to know?
See the world as it really is. Get the 12 biggest lies today. Available now at selected retailers and online everywhere.
Welcome back to Live Prayer. You know, I wish I could say every morning I wake up and nothing surprises me anymore, but I honestly can't say that. I woke up the other